Enter his gates with thanksgiving in your heart, for he has made me glad. He has made me glad. He has made me glad. Jesus has made me glad. Enter his courts with thanksgiving in your heart, for he has made me glad.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Praise the Lord.
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 Hallelujah.
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 My dear friends, in Jesus Christ, today church celebrates Feast of Saint Rita. Rita from Italy, her parents were farmers. Several years after marriage, they had no children. Almost daily crying in the presence of God, they cried and interceded Mother Mary for a child. After several years, God heard their prayer and gifted with a baby girl. Her name baptized as a Rita. From the childhood onwards, she was very pious and regular to the church holy masses. At the age of 12 onwards, she was often visiting Benedictine convent. By seeing their life, prayer life, their charitable works, she wanted to become a nun. And she expressed her obedience to become a nun. But parents denied. At the age of 18, married to a young man, he was almost daily beating her. No fear of God, no faith in God, lived according to the worldly concepts and beating. They had two children, one is John and second one is Paul. She thought at least after the birth of two sons, he may change in his attitudes, but still he was going on beating her. She was daily crying in the presence of God, and she was praying for her husband to change her heart, to change her attitudes. At last, he has changed. But a couple of years, his enemies stabbed him to death. And she was broken again. And she suffered a lot. After this incident, her sons, John and Paul, wanted to take revenge over who killed their parent. Then she was praying for sons not to take revenge. And at last she was praying, Heavenly Father, either you change their heart not to murder, not to kill, not to take revenge. Otherwise, take them to heaven. So her prayers was heard. They both taken to heaven. Then she was regularly going. And she expressed that she wanted to become a nun. But superior as well as community members, they said, you already married. You cannot become a nun. Since you are married, you cannot become a nun. But still, she was praying to St. Augustine, St. Benedict, St. John the Baptist, and Christopher. Daily she was praying that she want to become a nun. At last, one day, she was praying during night. There convent chapels, gates, everything was closed. When they opened, that Rita was praying in their chapel. By seeing, they were surprised. They asked, how do you came here? Because everything was locked. Then she said, Augustine, Christopher, John the Baptist brought me here. When she said they believed her words, they believed the love of God, and they accepted her. And she became a nun and she was doing charitable works, and whenever possible, she was praying in front of Eucharist. And she suffered a lot. Once she had a thorn from Jesus' head, thorn on her forehead. And she suffered a lot. She prayed, Lord Jesus, remove this thorn, because it was paining. Sometimes it was rotten smell. That's why the convent sister said, you don't come to chapel, you pray in your room itself, because they are not able to bear that smell. But everything she dedicated for the sake of Jesus. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Yes, my dear friends, in Jesus Christ, in today's gospel, Jesus telling vine and branches. Jesus is vine, we are branches. As long as we are connected with Jesus, we have to give good fruits. That's what Heavenly Father expects. All the qualities, all the characters, all the values of Jesus must be seen in our life, because as we are connected with Jesus. When branches connected with vine, definitely it gives good fruits. And now and then, trimming, cutting, manuring, all those things happening. In the same manner, whenever we do mistakes, commit sins, God is forgiving us. With His precious blood, He is forgiving us. And He is accepting again and again as sons and daughters of Jesus Christ. So as long as we connected with Jesus, Holy Spirit will guide us. Each and every moment, how to live, what to talk, everything Holy Spirit will teach us, we can learn from Holy Spirit. And we can be guided by Holy Spirit. Let us surrender ourselves and let us recall all our shortcomings and failures to participate in a worthy manner. I confess to Almighty God
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, and in what I failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, our Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Bestow on us, we pray, O Lord, the wisdom and strength of the cross, with which you were pleased to endow Saint Rita, so that suffering in every tribulations with Christ, we may participate ever more deeply in His Paschal mystery, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Paul and Barnabas and some others were appointed to go to Jerusalem to the apostles and the elders about the question. First reading. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 15, verses 1 to 6. Some men came down from Judah and were teaching the brethren, unless you are circumcised according to the custom of Moses, you cannot be saved. And when Paul and Barnabas had no small dissensions and debit with them, Paul and Barnabas and some of the others were appointed to go up to Jerusalem to the apostles and the elders about this question. So, being sent on this way by the church, they passed through both Phoenicia and Samaria, reporting the conversion of the Gentile. And they gave great joy to all the brethren. When they came to Jerusalem, they were welcomed by the church and the apostles and the elders, and they declared all that God had done with them. But some believed who belonged to the party of the Pharisees rose up and said, This is necessary to circumcise them and to change and to charge them to keep the law of Moses. The apostles and the elders were gathered together to consider this matter. The word of the God.
Thanks be to God.
Our response: I rejoice when I hear them say, "Let us go to the God's house."
I rejoice when I hear them say, "Let us go to the God's house."
I rejoice when I hear them say, "Let us go to the God's house." And now our feet are strengthening within your gates, O Jerusalem. Our response: I rejoice when I hear them say, "Let us go to the God's house." Jerusalem is built as a city, strongly compact. I response: I rejoice when I hear them say, "Let us go to the God's house." It is there that the tribes go up, the tribes of the Lord. I response: I rejoice when I hear them say, "Let us go to God's house." For Israel, law it is. There to preach the Lord's name. They were set to the thrones of judgment of the house of David. Our response: I rejoice when I hear them say, "Let us go to God's house." Acclamation.
Be with you
and with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Gospel of John, chapter 15, verses 1 to 18. I am the true vine, and my Father is the vine grower. If any of my branches does not bear fruit, he breaks it off. And he prunes every branch that does not bear fruit, that it may bear even more fruit. You are already made clean by the word I have spoken to you. Live in me as I live in you. The branches cannot bear fruit by itself, but has to remain part of the vine. So neither can you if you don't remain in me. I am the vine and you are the branches. As long as you remain in me and I in you, you bear much fruit, but apart from me you cannot do nothing. Whoever does not remain in me is thrown away as they do with the branches, and they wither. Then they are gathered and thrown into the fire and burned. If you remain in me and my words remain in you, you may ask whatever you want and it will be given to you. My Father is glorified when you bear much fruit. It is then that you became my disciple. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Abba, Father, let us be yours and yours alone. Set our hearts, our spirits free. Make us, Lord, your own. Through your goodness, Lord, we bring bread of our labor and wine to cheer the heart, which will soon be filled for us with the life of your Son. Abba, Father, let us be yours and yours alone. Set our hearts of spirits free. Make us, Lord, your own.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise, for the good and good of all his holy church.
Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these paschal mysteries, so that the renewed, constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time, above all, to lord you yet more gloriously. When Christ our Passover has been sacrificed, he never ceased to offer himself for us, but defends us and every pleads our causes before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, gave to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Tumabala our Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember also, brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coheirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At Xavier's command, formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, Hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who call to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. My heart's like a flute and I want to play all day. Jesus Christ is my music, master deep. From my heart flows a simple melody. Great is his love, love without end. Great is his love, love without end. Once I met the Lord on the way. Deep was his gaze, kind was his smile, true were his words, gentle his touch. He brought me peace and freedom. My heart's like a flute and I want to play all day. Jesus Christ is my music, master deep. From my heart flows a simple melody. Great is his love, love without end. Great is his love, love without end.
Let us pray. Hear, O Lord, our prayers, that this most holy exchange by which you have redeemed us may bring your help in this present life and ensure for us eternal gladness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Almighty God bless you. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Mass is ended. Go and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God. No one can live as an island, journeying through life alone.